wonderful show for you performed by some of the best students that Northeast Magnet has to offer. But in order to enhance your evening, we ask that you follow a few rules for us. First of all, please turn off all cell phones, pagers, anything that could cause a distraction. I'll give you a few seconds to do that right now. I don't have a watch, so this is kind of pointless. We good? All right. And then second of all, no flash photography. It's very distracting, and it also angers the werewolves. We don't want that happening this evening. It happened last night, and we had to call the ambulance, and it wasn't good. The students you are about to see have been working for 7 weeks, working so hard on this musical, so please be respectful of not only those around you, but them, and enjoy the show.
Frankenstein creatures came ramming into my ship. I tried to stop them, but I couldn't.
arm or the leg. You're about to get to the village, idiot. Beware of the Frankenstein. I may be a village idiot, but I ask you, what are the chances of a New York doctor coming to Transylvania?
Independently of the will. Why, you dirty, rotten...
Though I almost ate him, his reflexes have the freedom to react when I was treated. It's important I explain. Synaptic nerve connection goes its way without detection, bringing cranial protection in a never-ending chain. That's what I love about the brain. But what if we were to block these moving pulses by simply applying local pressure? Which can be done with any ordinary metal clamp, just if the swelling of the posterior nerve root for, oh, say about 4 seconds. You mother grabbing gun! As you can see, even though I've just smashed my knee into his crotch, he doesn't react. He feels absolutely nothing. More or less. So, if it were not for this constant stream of motor impulses from the brain, we would all collapse like a bunch of broccoli!
Oh.
Everybody!
Dream all you want, my darling.
Frankenstein! My name is pronounced Frankenstein.
You're pulling my leg.
No, I'm not.
Then your first name. Do you pronounce it Frederick?
No, Frederick.
Really? Well, why isn't it Frederick Frankenstein?
Because it isn't.
As you wish, Master.
Oh, Master. You must be Igor.
It's pronounced Igor.
They told me it was Igor.
Well, they were wrong then, weren't they? You know, Master, my grandfather used to look for your grandfather.
Oh, really? How nice.
And it's always been a dream of mine ever since I was little that one day I would work for you, just as my grandfather worked for yours. Of course, great to have one now.
Of course.
Working at your side would be a joy, Master. We can open up the old laboratory, reconnect the voltometer. Dust off the lightning rods, and when everything's in tip-top working order, we can go down to the graveyard at midnight and dig up a nice, big, fresh corpse.
I don't think you understand. I wouldn't. I couldn't.
Oh, the fantastic things we'll do. It'll be like old times, you and me. Right up there, with the world's greatest pairs. Like Lord McCartney, White Cat, and the Carney, like Jimmy, yes, and Romeo, Kevin. Together, together, and then.
Together.
my grandfather's estate, and then I'm heading straight back to New York. No laboratories, no creatures.
Hey, you changed your mind, Master. Come on, join in the Tories, it's fun!
My dear Igor, I happen to be the Dean of Anatomy at a world-renowned school of medicine. Although I do sing a bit, and was, in fact, a whiffin' poof at Yale.
A whiffin' poof? Wow! Come on, Doc, no one's around.
Well, nobody's around. What the heck? Together again for the first time. Have to mourn, have it go on. No longer bad and a cursed time. It's easy to see.
You have to agree.
We're destined to be a great pair.
May I take it?
All of my life I've been bossing around. Mean and alone like a Scrooge. All of my life I've been bossing around. But what good is a boss if he ain't got a stooge? Oh, I'm sorry. I don't wish to embarrass you, but I am a rather brilliant surgeon. Perhaps I can help you with that help.
Watch out.
Together again for the first time. We've only met in a dream. Like Ginger and Freddy.
Donald and Eddie.
Like San Juan and Teddy.
Or meatballs and spaghetti.
But the pair that we cry for, the pair that we sigh for, the pair that we die for, is Frankenstein and Igor.
For
the first time, together again.
Walk this way. No, this way, like this. Make it creepy. Regular foot.
Regular foot.
Here we go. 1, 6, 7.
Together again for the first time. We've only met in a dream. Like Gimbal and Macy.
Like Hepburn and Tracy.
Like Lombard and Gable.
Like good old Cain and Abel for the first time. Together again. Together forever again. Hey, horsey, climb aboard, Master, and blow me off the Castle Frankenstein, where I will work humbly at your side as you begin a new set of historic experiments.
Igor, how many times do I have to tell you? I have no wish to continue my grandfather's wacky work.
Really? Well, I even went so far as to hire a local girl, Inga, to assist you in your wacky work.
Well, you shouldn't have, because I will have absolutely no use.
Oh, hello!
This is the girl, Inga.
How do you do, Doctor?
How do you do?
I have a master's degree in laboratory science from Heidelberg Junior College. I can fulfill all your needs. I'm a very hard worker, and if needed, I'll bend over backwards for you.
What do you say, Doc? Should I fire her?
Well, I would definitely like to sleep on... think about it! By the way, how are we getting to the castle?
A wee straw bed and schlagen bagen suchen fruchen.
What's that?
A haybine!
Yeah.
to Castle Frankenstein! I'll let them know we're here.
Wow, what knockers.
chaos since 1201. Passed on for generations, father to son. Descended from gypsies, as proud as we can be. Don't risk my curse, it could be worse. Embrace your family. Make yourself a monster, make the world afraid. Join the family business, you must take the family name. Follow in our footsteps and you'll win eternal fame. The Rothenbergs are celebrated for their Roquefort cheese. The Rothschilds are famous for their wines. Hershey's have their chocolates and Lipton's have their teas. But when it comes to making monsters, eat the Frankensteins. Join the family business. Rob a grave or two. Stop the shop from closing. It all depends on you. Uphold the family honor. You must toe the family line. Join the family business. Join the family business. Join the family business. For your name is Frankenstein. Meet your family.
Really?
there's some kind of switch to activate the secret passageway in the bookshelf. A triggering mechanism. Aha! Nope. Ah! Nope. Inga, hand me a candle, would you? Inga.
Put the candle back! Look, Doctor, a hidden passageway.
Well, wherever that music was, it's from somewhere inside. I'm going to investigate.
Oh, let me go with you. I'm afraid to stay here all alone.
Okay, then. Close your robe and follow me.
I in wedlock. He put me in a headlock. Then I asked to be his final stabby with a kitchen knife. Ah, I did the good done
go. If he had a daybreak bit, I was the first thing that he did till I didn't give a flip. He burnt my own brain. Yes!
Frankenstein. Ridiculous. As I began my experiments, I came to realize that creating life after death would be difficult, but with a little luck, I could make it work. Preposterous. Change the poles from plus to minus, and from minus to plus, of course.
Let's see, lucky number.
I-27!
After years of ceaseless labor, I alone had succeeded in discovering the secret of bestowing life. Nay, even more, I myself became capable of bestowing animation upon lifeless matter. It could work!
Breaking wheels. Careful. home by the neck until somebody's dead!
His brilliant new brain is in place. Wait a minute. Wasn't your hump on the left?
What?
Your hump. Wasn't it on the left side? Never mind. The storm is directly above us. There's no better time. Igor.
Yes, master.
Generator on, please.
Yes, master. Generator on.
Now! Now! Release the safety valve for the main switch.
Yes, master.
Thank you.
Igor, shut everything off.
Yes, master.
Not a sign. Not a spark. Nothing. I failed. I've readily failed.
Sorry, master.
Well, I don't get it. It worked for Victor, and he couldn't even sing.
Oh, Doctor, I feel so bad for you.
No, no. Be of good cheer, all of you. If science teaches us anything, it's to accept our successes as well as our failures. With quiet, dignity, and grace.
Why would you do this? Why? I'll get you for this!
No, stop it! No!
Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! You'll kill him!
And he's not even alive!
I don't want to live! I don't want to live! I don't want to live!
Quiet, dignity, and grace. Come on, Doc.
Just in our imagination.
Just visual sinking.
Visual sinking my platoony!
It's alive! It's alive! It's alive! My creation!
Oh, Doctor, Doctor, you've done it! I could just kiss you.
So could I!
No, no, stand back, all of you. Give him some room. Would you like me to set you free? Good. I'm going to set you free.
I'm not nervous about this. Are you nervous about this?
I'm not nervous about this.
Would you like us to set you up? Good. Set him up. So, You're telling me that I put an abnormal brain into an almost 7-foot-tall, 4-foot-wide gorilla? Is that what you're telling me?
Give him the brain! Get...
Let's all be Zania-y.